We are now at section 15.7, the Van de Graaff generator. Let's bring up the PowerPoint. And in 1929, Robert J. Van de Graaff, who lived from 1901 to 1967, designed and built an electrostatic generator that is used extensively in nuclear physics research. The figure on the left shows the basic construction of this device. A motor-driven pulley P moves a belt past positively charged comb-like magnetic needles positioned at A. Negative charges are attracted to these needles from the belt, leaving the left side of the belt with a net positive charge. The positive charges attract electrons onto the belt as it moves past the second comb of needles at B, increasing the excess positive charge on the dome. Because the electric field inside the metal dome is negligible, the positive charges on it can easily be increased regardless of how much charge is already present. The result is that the dome is left with a large amount of positive charge. This accumulation of charge on the dome can't continue indefinitely. As more and more charge appears on the surface of the dome, the magnitude of the electric field at that surface also increases. Finally, the strength of the field becomes great enough to partially ionize the air near the surface, increasing the conductivity of the air. Charges on the dome now have a pathway to leak off into the air, producing some spectacular lightning bolts as the discharge occurs, as you can see in the photo at the right. And next, we'll discuss the electric flux.